Well, Mrs. McCain, you are the star of our little show here, so I want you, just in your own words, to share with me your perspective of why you think your son is the perfect choice for president in 2008.
Well, I figured out he served in the military for over 20 years. He served in the Congress for 4 years, and he's been in the Senate for over 20 years. I don't know of anyone else in America in any role of life that is more qualified than he is to be president of the United States. And I've just given you the reasons why. On top of that, you have a man who is, his whole life is dedicated to God and his country and to try to make a difference. I think that's been proven in almost everything he's ever done.
Now you can see why I have her traveling with me.
She's pretty good. She knows what she's doing.
Yes,
well,
she does.
I've answered your question. And I have a slogan.
What's your slogan?
In fact, the Senator Brownback gave me the idea that McCain is the full package. I think that's an athletic expression. Mm-hmm. But he is the full package. It isn't learning on the job. It isn't equivocating and changing his mind about certain stands that he's taken. He's been consistent every time in his entire life and loyal to the Republican Party. He's never gone against anything that I know of. So you've got this full package. You have a man, you know everything about him. And you're not going to find out anything different between now and the election. So that's why I not only think so, I'm certain that he is. Now, I'm not going to say that he's going to be elected, but it will be not to the best interest of the United States of America if he isn't elected.
Let me ask something that I know the senator's been forced to have to answer at different places before, but I'd like to get your perspective on the whole age issue thing.
Oh, yeah.
What's
well,
your
it
take?
Is an issue. It is an issue. And I think there are a lot of 71-year-old people that would be too old. But this man, openly, everyone knows, he works 7 days a week. He works 15, 16, 17 hours a day, 52 weeks out of the year. In the 04 election, working for other Democrats for the election, nothing for him in 04, he'd be in three states in one day, making three or four, five, six campaign speeches every day and going to work. So a man who does that, I don't think that it is an age question.
Well, it also certainly seems that in the family,
oh, well,
doing just fine.
Well, maybe I've lived too long, but I've had almost 86 years of the happiest time. I'm the happiest person and the luckiest person in the world.
Good for you. And you must have, could you tell at an early age, I mean, the military service, we know his storied past with the military service, but could you tell at an early age that he was destined for a leadership job?
No, I never thought about it.
Is that right?
No, because I thought he'd always be in the Navy until his retirement time.
Makes sense. What did you think of his decision to run to get involved in politics after the war?
I didn't give it much thought. See, again, it's to serve God and your country. A man who's been in the Navy as long as that is, who's been in the, what he's been through, would go to Arizona and love and enjoy his family and say, I'm finished. I've had a career. Who else you know goes around and starts all over again?
That's a good point. That's a good point. What do you think of this? God, mom, country? I think we've got this covered, Senator.
Well, it's true. And this is very important to this country that we're in trouble throughout the world. And I think it's absolutely vital that we get somebody that knows your man is of integrity, you know that what he tells you is the truth, and that he's going to do the best job he knows how. He's not going to be a perfect job. But I'll guarantee you what he does is for the better good of this world.
I see where the straight talk comes from.
Yes.
I've never talked like this before because no one's ever asked me before.
Well, I'm glad that I'm the first to be able to do it then.
Well, you're going
to
be sorry before it's over.
You know, Scott, one of the kind of interesting things about my mom growing up, two comments. One is that my father, being a naval officer and gone during World War II, he was gone during Korea. A lot of time, our father was her husband was missing from the family, and that's the nature of the business of being in the professional military. And I'm not saying it was wrong or bad, but it does place all over military families a greater burden on the spouse. The spouse has to be the one that raises the family while the other one is out overseas in combat or not in combat. So my mom played a very big role in our upbringing. She always kept the memory and the vision, and talked about my father all the time. But the fact is, he was gone for 4 years, practically speaking, all in World War II, and then for a couple of years during Korea. But the other thing is, my mother was always, and she may deny this, but she was always very keenly interested in politics. When my dad was stationed in the Pentagon, she would go to and we lived on Capitol Hill, she would go over to the hearings all the time and see them. She paid close attention to races. And military families are generally apolitical, but she was really a very keen observer of government and politics. Isn't that an accurate
statement? That is true, and I have, yeah, it's true.
She went to the Alger Hiss Whitaker Chambers hearings.
And I still have the hearings.
Is that right?
In print.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
And so I may have gotten some of this inclination towards the political life from her, much more so than my father, who was really apolitical. I mean, he was just the classic kind of pre-World War II naval officer that felt that there was a great division between anything in politics and service in the military. They was totally divorced.